With the introduction of innovative, modern, minimally invasive glaucoma surgery, recently there is an increasing interest in intraoperative observation of the anterior chamber angle. Traditional intraoperative angle viewing systems are the handheld Goldman gonioscope and the Swan-Jacob gonioprism. The Goldman gonioscope is not very useful for intraoperative application because it's too bulky and the image is mirrored. The Swan-Jacob lens is much more popular, but to have an adequate view to the anterior chamber angle, it needs a longer learning curve and sometimes it's difficult to stabilize the eye during the surgery. Additionally, only monomanual manipulations are possible. Vitreoretinal surgery, traditionally intraoperatively, a special contact lens was used to visualize the fundus. This required an assistant to center the contact lens on the cornea. But more than a decade ago, microscope-mounted non-contact wide-angle viewing systems revolutionized vitreoretinal surgery. This video, we like to introduce a new microscope-mounted balanced angle viewing system. The aim of this development was to increase contact lens stabilization, improve intraoperative anterior chamber angle observation, and to allow bimanual manipulations in the anterior chamber angle. The microscope-mounted Chariot angle viewing system allows a hand-free stabilization of the gonioprism and gives an excellent and stable view of the anterior chamber angle. After the focus of the angle viewing system is set, HPMC is placed on the cornea. The foot pedal of the microscope is used to center the lens and to zoom the image if needed. In this case, we like to show a bimanual trabecular aspiration. The soft-tipped cannula is placed directly over the trabecular meshwork, and under high vacuum it is moved gently over the trabeculum. Note the clear and stable view of the anterior chamber angle. The second hand is used for irrigation and stabilization of the eye during the procedure. In modern minimally invasive glaucoma surgery, a stable and clear intraoperative view of the anterior chamber angle is mandatory to identify anatomical landmarks. In this case, we would like to show the implantation of a new implant for trabecular bypass surgery. The Hydrus is a flexible implant made from nitinol to scaffold Schlemm's canal over a distance of about 10 mm. It is implanted up internal with the help of a specially designed inserter. The proximal end should be placed that the opening is in the anterior chamber. This will allow a bypass between AC and Schlemm's canal to reduce the resistance to outflow. If the surgeon is using a second instrument in his non-dominant hand to stabilize the eye during the surgery, this instrument could be used for intraocular manipulations as well. This is a case of cyclodialysis cleft syndrome after a complicated trabeculotomy in a case of congenital glaucoma. After 1 year of unexplained hypotonia and several re-interventions, the patient was referred to us for secondary opinion. The anterior chamber was filled with viscoelastic device and under direct view of the anterior chamber angle diagnosis was proven. We decided for cyclodialysis repair with an up-internal placement of several 10-0 polypropylene sutures. With the help of Chariot's angle viewing system, bimanual intra or even extraocular manipulations are possible. Here, the second instrument is used to allow needle penetration through the sclera. After successful repair of the cyclodialysis cleft, IOP in this case returned to normal values. The pupil, thanks to the intraocular approach, was only minimally distorted towards the sutures. Chariot angle viewing system is a new hands-free system for intraoperative observation of the anterior chamber angle. Compared to traditional handheld gonio lenses, we found better intraoperative image control and lens stabilization. The new opportunity for bimanual intraoperative intraocular manipulations might lead to new surgical approaches in the anterior chamber angle surgery.